Dear students, welcome to today's lecture on classification and setting reaction of dental amalgam. I am Dr. Pawan. Dental amalgam is the alloy that is formed by reacting of mercury with silver, copper and tin, and which may also contain palladium, zinc and other elements to improve handling characteristics and clinical performance. Based on the copper content, amalgam alloys can be classified as low copper and high copper alloys. Low copper alloys generally contains less than 5% of the copper, whereas high copper amalgams mainly contains 13 to 30%. These high copper alloys are also divided into unicomposition alloys and admixed alloys. In admixed alloys, there are two components. One part of the silver copper eutectic spherical alloy is mixed with two parts of the silver tin alloy of lathe cut particles, and unicompositional spherical alloys. These are formed by melting high copper alloy powder and atomizing the molten liquid results in formation of unicompositional alloys. These unicompositional alloys generally consist of about 30% of the copper, whereas an admixed alloy consists of 13% of the copper. The role of copper generally is it strengthens the matrix or strengthens the amalgam restorations. High copper amalgams are known to have high strength, corrosion resistance, marginal integrity and overall clinical performance is better than that of the low copper amalgams. Based on the zinc content, the amalgam alloys can also be divided into two types: zinc containing alloys which contains greater than 0.01% of the zinc, and zinc free alloys which contains less than 0.01% of the zinc. The role of zinc is it acts as a deoxidizer and makes the amalgam restoration plastic and manipulation ability is improved. But in the absence of the zinc, the plastic nature decreases and brittle, which makes condensation and carving difficult. Based on the particle size, amalgam alloys can also be classified as lathe cut alloys, spherical alloys, and mixture of both is known as admixed alloys. The lathe cut alloys are formed by grinding in a milling machine and they have irregular size. Because of the irregular size, what will happen is they require more amount of the mercury to add it during manipulation. Hence, there will be more porous after the set cement is present. Whereas in spherical alloys, they are regular in shape and they have more surface areas due to the spherical nature of the particles, so less mercury is required. It is generally about 42%, whereas that mercury required for the lathe cut alloys is about 50%. Lathe cut alloys can be condensed and contoured as per the proximal contact areas, whereas the spherical alloys are difficult to condense and contour because they tend to stick to the instrument used to condense them. Gallium based alloys. Gallium is liquid at room temperature, so the combination of gallium and indium results in a cold weldable mass. This can be used as an alternative to mercury dental amalgam to prevent the after effects of the mercury. But the main disadvantages of this gallium based alloys are it tends to expand more, thereby creating pressure on the tooth, causing pain and sometimes fracture also. Amalgamation. It is a process of mixing liquid mercury with one or more metal alloys to form an amalgam, whereas trituration is mixing the amalgam alloy particles with the mercury in device called triturator. Once the titration occurs, the mercury will amalgam that is formed will start to set. Setting reaction generally involves dissolution of silver and tin particles into the mercury, and silver, as it is least soluble in mercury, precipitates to form gamma 1 particles. These gamma 1 precipitates forms a matrix that binds unreacted particles, and later the tin particles react with mercury to form gamma 2 phase. This is weak phase and it tends to undergo corrosion. Okay, and then the gamma 2 phase is the weakest phase. And in low copper alloys, the mercury is mixed with alloy particles 1:1 ratio, and the unreacted particles are known as gamma phase, and the reaction between silver and mercury results in gamma 1 phase, which is a matrix that binds the unreacted particles, and gamma 2 phase is a tin mercury phase, which is weakest phase and is least resistant to corrosion. In high copper admixed alloy, the same reaction will occur, except that the presence of eutectic silver copper will result in formation of neta phase due to the reaction between the copper of eutectic mixture with the tin of the gamma 2 phase. Both results in formation of neta. As a result, the gamma 2 phase will degrade over a period of time. So the minimum concentration of the copper to fully replace the gamma 2 phase is 11.8%. In high copper unicompositional alloys, there is little amount of gamma 2 phase is released, and the silver tin phase and copper tin phase reacts with the mercury to form the gamma 1 phase and neta phase. This neta phase is also known as neta prime phase, as it is as this phase is more stable at the room temperature, and this neta prime phase will tend to bind the unreacted gamma phases and also gets embedded in the matrix formed by the gamma 1 phase. This neta phase, what will it do is, it interlocks with the particles of the gamma 1 phase and thereby prevents the delayed expansion in future. Thank you.